Since the 7th century, Korea was a unified country. After the war between Japan and China in 1894 and 1895, many parts of Korea were occupied by Japan. In August 1910, Japan took control of all of Korea. During World War II, Korea was divided into two countries at the 38th parallel. North Korea was the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, and South Korea was the Republic of Korea. Towards the end of World War II, the United States occupied South Korea, and the Soviet Union occupied North Korea. With this occupation, Japan lost control of Korea. However, neither the United States nor the Soviet Union pulled out of Korea. The end of Japan's control brought the end of World War II and the start of the Cold War. Every national conflict became a competition between the Soviet Union and the United States. The Soviet Union wanted to spread communism throughout the world. They helped North Korea to become a communist country. The Soviet Union also supported and supplied North Koreans' occupation of South Korea. On June 25, 1950, North Korean forces crossed the 38th parallel with tanks, planes, and armies. South Korea was at a clear disadvantage to the more experienced North Korea. President Truman immediately ordered American troops to Korea to stop the North Korean advances. President Truman feared that if North Korea was not stopped, the Third World War would begin. The first battle between America and North Korean forces on June 25th did not go well for the Americans. The Americans and South Koreans fought desperately to delay North Korean forces until more troops arrived. By the end of July, the North Koreans pushed the UN forces to the southeast corner of the Korean Peninsula around the port of Busan. The course of the war then changed when an amphibious attack at the port of Incheon near Seoul was launched. American forces then captured the port of Incheon, recaptured the city of Seoul, and cut off the supply lines to North Korea. America then pushed across the 38th parallel and launched an all-out offensive attack to the Yalu River. However, the Chinese launched 300,000 troops against American troops on November 25th. The Americans were pushed back down the Korean Peninsula, losing Seoul. On June 25th, the UN began a slow advance north. Seoul was captured on March 15th, and patrols were established at the 38th parallel 2 weeks later. On July 27, 1953, a ceasefire agreement was signed and a demilitarized zone was established around the 38th parallel. However, this ceasefire agreement only brought a halt to the hostile actions and the war is not technically over. America still has troops and soldiers patrolling the 38th parallel. One of those soldiers was George. George was born at 10th and National in Milwaukee in 1942. When he was born, his father was serving in World War II. His mother worked odd jobs to support the family until his father came home. When he came home, the family opened a gas station and store. George had a great childhood. He enjoyed school and classes, especially woodworking, swim, art, and math class. He loved to take care of the geese, chickens, and ducks at home. Things went very well until George's mom got very sick and died on her birthday in 1953.
Then we pretty well scattered all over the city. Then things got a little hairy. I went from school to school. I had to lie about my age and go to work at a bowling alley. I figured after when I turned 18, I couldn't take it anymore at working at night and trying to go to school during the day. Then I enlisted in the National Guard for 6 months. Then after I got out of 6 months of National Guard, then I enlisted in the Army in 1960. Then in the summer of 61, I went to Korea for 13 months.
George was one of the soldiers that went to Korea during peacetime where the conditions were very cold with no snow in the winter and warm in the summers. He went through basic training but asked to be a cook to follow his father in what he did in World War II.
I was a cook over there. Then a couple of months into there, we had to go up to the 38th parallel to get the camp ready for the regulars. And then we were put in full battle gear. We had to get in full battle gear because the village was right down the hill from us. And we had to protect ourselves. And they were going pretty crazy down there in the village. Yeah. Other than that, it was pretty peaceful. Yeah. Pretty well, it was like a waiting game over on the 38th parallel. Yeah. Because we didn't know what was going to happen from day to day.
When George was in Korea, he formed tight bonds with many of the soldiers.
Especially amongst the cooks. Because every payday, we'd line up the counter with cold cuts and that, and all the cooks would go in the back room and play poker. Yeah, we had some good times. Yeah. After I got discharged from the military, I had to go look for a job. Yeah. Jobs were hard to find back then. Was a security guard, worked in a plating outfit, worked in a construction outfit. Otherwise, it's been pretty quiet. I was a chaplain in the village BFW, county council chaplain, fourth district chaplain. Otherwise, other than that, my life's been pretty quiet. I married into a ready-made family. She was, I think I was in my 40s or 50s, something like that. And we had about 6 years of marriage, and then she got real sick, and she died in 91. She was buried over in Woods Hospital. Her name is on one side of the tomb. My name is on the other. See, like, I made a system where at breakfast I worked on my word search book, and for lunch and supper I do my painting. I painted bunny rabbits, hearts, Christmas bells, the Virgin Mary and Jesus, all kinds of different products, yeah. They wanted me to go over to Korea. I'd be there in a heartbeat. Oh, yeah.
Do you think the Korean War was successful?
Huh?
Do you think it was successful?
All it is right now is peacetime. Mm-hmm. What I'm talking about is armistice. That can start up again anytime.
The Korean War is known as the Forgotten War, but who could ever forget it? Korea is still divided to this day, and the war could start up at any moment. There are thousands of Korean families that have not had any contact because of the division. This war caused the tension to grow between the Soviet Union and the United States because it showed that the United States would stop at nothing to prevent the spread of communism, even though they paid a heavy price. The Korean War was one of the bloodiest wars in American history. China lost up to 1 million soldiers, and the U.S. suffered 36,934 dead and 103,284 wounded. Other U.N. nations suffered 3,222 dead and 11,949 wounded.
I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain, the only thing that's real. The needle tears a hole, the old familiar sting. Try to kill it all away. but I remember everything. What have I become?